now that Tesla was fortunately allowed to continue working at Giga Berlin. We can see extremely fast progress at Grünheide, in best Tesla manner. Then let's also talk about the amazing giant 1 GWh battery pack planned for California. And people who ridiculed Cybertruck now have a rude awakening. The Tesla Cybertruck now has over 500,000 pre-orders. And what is the so-called competition doing meanwhile anyways?
Then we'd also like to talk about Uber Air plans for 1,000 flying air taxi strong fleet in Melbourne, about the unfortunate fire at Lilium, and about the safety of flying air taxis in general. And while on the topic of flying things, Elon said that the era of fighter jets is now over and the era of drones has begun. Then we have some news regarding Hyperloop, because we have new possible routes being considered in Italy and one more in the US. A lot of stuff happening as always, so stay tuned.
So now that the whole court drama with Tesla Giga Berlin is over, and reason and logic have fortunately prevailed, work on the future Gigafactory in Grünheide near Berlin is progressing further at insane speeds. Exactly as we came to know and love Tesla. The whole area now has been cleared of trees. And not only that, but also power lines are already being drawn. We can already see quite a few electric power lines being dug into the ground in these shots here. However, the water and sewage supply lines still have to be drawn. The 17-year-old Amy Zenke has released an excellent animation so that we can imagine how the future Giga Berlin will look like when finished some point next year. In other news, Tesla is planning to build a gigantic 1 GWh battery pack for PG&E at Moss Landing Power Facility in California. It would have been even cooler if it would have been 1.21 GWh. You know, as a nod to Back to the Future. But 1 GWh is already very impressive as it is. That's 1,000 MWh or 1 million kWh. So this new giant Tesla Gigapack will have the storing capacity of 10,000 Model S's.
It will of course act as a buffer battery for the nearby solar and wind farms, and there are fortunately quite a few of those in California, as we found out ourselves when we drove around Cali a few months ago. Renewables are growing like crazy all around the world and also in the US. And California is leading the charge here with already over 50% of electricity created with non-CO2 emitting methods. Solar and wind alone already make up 23% of the total energy mix. This is just amazing. And of course, in order to allow solar and wind farms to store energy during peak hours, very large battery packs are needed. And this is exactly where the future Gigapack will come in. In Hornsdale, Australia, the 129 megawatt hours Tesla Megapack has already been successfully running now since late 2017 and will be expanded soon to almost 200 megawatt hours. This battery pack saved consumers already $116 million worth of electricity by 2019. So not only are these Tesla Mega or Gigapacks making solar and wind farms extremely viable, but no, they also allow consumers to save a lot of money by flattening out electricity spikes or lows, thus also making the whole electric grid more robust. So the Gigapack for California is just awesome news and another reason why renewable energy will just continue to become the dominating form of electricity generation very, very soon worldwide. Much faster than many people would suspect. Hint, logistics S-curve, friends, the famous logistics S-curve again, which describes the growth of disruptive technologies, is again at work here.
While on the topic of Tesla, the Cybertruck now has over 500,000 pre-orders. According to CybertruckOwnersClub.com, 535,000 as of the 19th of February. Many were ridiculing Tesla at the unveil. What a huge mistake they made. Well, we were of course absolutely blown away by the retro-futuristic brutalist design, low price, and amazing specs. Sure, the down payment is only $100. But still, Normally, the number of reservations is a reliable indication for how high the demand will actually be, as the reservations for the Model 3 had shown. So the Cybertruck has 535,000 pre-orders, exactly 3 months after its unveil. As a comparison, the Model 3 had 400,000 reservations 3 months after its unveil in early 2016. And as we know, the Model 3 is just killing all other EVs. Nay, not only EVs, but also gasoline cars in general. So in our opinion, pre-orders are a good estimate on how well a car will actually sell. The Tesla Cybertruck will become an insane success story, and many will then start to copy the Cybertruck. Mark our words. We will see many copycats after the Cybertruck will hit the streets in 2021, trying to become the next cyber vehicle. This will lead to more radical and futuristic car design in general, a thing which is already long overdue in our opinion, because we were promised cars like these already decades ago. And now, thanks to Tesla and Cybertruck, it will finally happen. And what are the other manufacturers doing meanwhile? Well, it turns out that they have severe problems with bringing their electric cars to market. Who would have thought? One problem is of course that none of the other car makers has such a good battery supply as Tesla has with their Panasonic and now also CATL partnership. Tesla has by far the highest battery supply. Many of the other car makers get their batteries from LG Chem. Unfortunately, LG Chem cannot keep up with the high demand. That's for example why the Audi e-tron production has now been temporarily halted. Audi just cannot get enough battery packs. That's why Audi will only be able to produce 40,000 Audi e-trons instead of 80,000 this year. Jaguar faces similar problems for their I-Pace, which also gets the batteries from LG Chem. And Mercedes too. Even Kia and Hyundai are affected, because they are also relying on the batteries from LG Chem. So we can see that relying on only one battery producer and not having battery production in-house can lead to massive problems. Another big issue of the other car makers is software. The launch of the VW ID.3 could be delayed because of massive software problems. As many as 300 errors per day are reported with many of their cars. VW originally planned to sell 40,000 ID.3s this year. Now they will be lucky to sell even half as many. We really hope that VW can get their problems fixed quickly, because we liked the ID.3 quite a lot when we saw it ourselves at the Frankfurt Motor Show last year. Let's hope that the other car makers get their problems under control, and that LG Chem can massively expand their battery production, because we really want to see more electric cars on the road.
And now from electric cars to another disruptive form of transport, namely flying air taxis, because we just love flying air taxis. Now first, unfortunately, some bad news from the electric air taxi startup Lilium, and which we hopefully will visit when the channel grows larger, to get a picture of the state of their Lilium jet and what they are actually doing there. So the bad news is that one of their two prototypes was unfortunately badly damaged beyond repair in a fire, and the other prototype is not flight ready yet. The prototype that burned was the one we can see flying in these shots here. So now hopefully they will get the second prototype flight ready as soon as possible, because the second prototype is a more advanced version of the first one. The Lilium air taxi is still in early development stages, and many actually question its specifications. When launched for commercial service around 2025, Lilium says that the air taxi should have a range of 300 kilometers and a top speed of around 300 kilometers per hour. Now the range of 300 kilometers is a lot more than other air taxi competitors, and we are really curious to see if they can actually deliver on this promise. Now a range of 300 kilometers in our opinion will certainly require higher energy density batteries of at least 400 watt hours per kilogram. The current energy density of around 250 watt hours per kilogram is not enough for such a range. However, future energy densities will allow for 400, even 500 watt-hours per kilogram thanks to Tesla's dry electrode anodes, of which we'll certainly learn more on the upcoming battery and drivetrain day. These energy densities would allow the Lilium Jet to reach the specified range. However, even if the range would only be 150 km instead of 300 km, it would still be amazing enough. Now, we will keep a close eye on the developments over at Lilium because they are not so far away from here and we certainly would like to visit them one day.
Meanwhile, a leak revealed Uber's plans for their flying air taxi service. We already talked about the trial runs in Guangzhou, China, with the Yihang air taxi, and in Christchurch, New Zealand, with the Kitty Hawk air taxi. Now it appears that another city which will soon see flying air taxis will be Melbourne in Australia. So Uber's documents, which were obtained under freedom of information laws, reveal that a fleet of up to 1,000 air taxis are planned for Melbourne, with 83 skyports. The air taxis will travel at a speed of up to 320 km per hour and at an altitude of around 500 meters. The noise level of these air taxis is said not to exceed 67 decibels at an altitude of 75 meters. The same noise level of a busy road, for example during rush hour traffic. And then air taxis will never be below 75 meters, since they will take off from and land on their skyports, which will be installed on tall buildings or on new tall buildings, especially built for that purpose. And there are two other cities where flying air taxi trials will happen very soon. Dallas, and get this, Los Angeles. Yes, yes, soon we will see flying cars in LA. A few years too late for the 2019 prediction from Blade Runner. But hey, at least soon we will be able to fly over LA as in freaking sci-fi movies. How awesome is that?
Now in Melbourne, meanwhile, it appears that Uber is closely working together with regulators to make it actually happen. And it appears that they are really open towards the idea, wanting to move forward and allow for air taxi legislation as soon as possible. Now, of course, there are still quite some hurdles though, so realistically we can expect regular operation of Uber Air maybe around the mid-2020s. The Uber Air taxis, as probably all flying air taxis, will be totally automated, flying themselves, and they can also be called via app. Now, in one of our last videos, which you can watch right here, we already talked about the safety of air taxis. They, of course, will have many redundant systems and also backup systems, and on top also parachutes. So in case of an emergency, they will glide down gently on a parachute. So the horror scenario of constantly crashing air taxis which fall onto our heads will not happen. Something which, by the way, cannot be said of helicopters. In the comment section, we were often a bit surprised that people would compare air taxis with helicopters. Absolutely no, helicopters and air taxis are not even remotely the same. Now, helicopters are much unsafer than air taxis, which has been unfortunately seen yet again with another tragic helicopter crash last week in which famous basketball player Kobe Bryant and his daughter and seven other people all died. Helicopters suck, okay? Helicopters suck. They are extremely loud, much louder than air taxis, by the way. They are not electric, so they run on combustion, and they have only one giant, non-redundant main rotor. Oh yeah, and no parachute safety system. If Kobe Bryant would have had the option to choose an Uber air taxi, he, his daughter, and the other seven people would still be alive.
Well, on the topic of flying things, we already mentioned Elon's Starfleet remarks and Starship for Space Force in our Monday's space video, which you can watch right here. On the same event, Elon also said that the era of fighter jets is over and autonomous drones are taking over. He also said that the US is risking to fall behind if it doesn't do more innovation and relies too much on one single system, for example the F-35 jet. Elon said a worthy competition to the F-35 jet would be a drone of some kind. Again, another instance where Elon is contemplating electric aircraft. we are pretty sure that he has something in his mind. And as always, since nobody else is doing it, Elon has to do it. When the battery energy density will increase to the necessary 400 or 500 watt-hour per kilogram in this decade, we could imagine him announcing the electric supersonic VTOL jet, and the military will be, of course, highly interested.
And lastly, a bit on current Hyperloop developments. Even though Hyperloop is getting a lot of negativity, we will never, never stop speaking of Hyperloop. Okay, forget it. Are there problems or hurdles to be overcome with Hyperloop? Sure. But you know, there was a time when problems were solved not because they were easy, but because they were hard. You know, remember this time? And this is why Hyperloop will be awesome. It will be hard to overcome these problems, of course, but they are solvable. Now, Jixuan and me often like to say that any problem, no matter how hard it is, can be overcome with good engineering and science as long as it doesn't contradict the laws of physics. So all supposed insolvable problems for Hyperloop can also be solved, of course. There's no problem contradicting the laws of physics. Oh yeah, and this Thunderfoot video, by the way, trying to debunk the Hyperloop? Now, we watched his video and many of the things he's saying are totally wrong. You know what? I think we'll actually do a debunk video of his video in one of our future episodes. We will debunk all his so-called arguments against Hyperloop. We will freaking debunk it. Anyways, back on topic, the Mid-Ohio Regional Planning Commission is considering a 30-year Midwest Connect plan to connect Pittsburgh and Chicago through Columbus with a 41-minute Hyperloop system. The group estimates roughly $300 billion in economic benefits for communities along the corridor and a sizable environmental benefit resulting in massively reduced CO2 emissions. So after the Great Lakes Hyperloop, after the Missouri Hyperloop, we could have another possible Hyperloop. And now another one joins the ranks of these Hyperloops, with Italy considering one for connecting the airport of Milan to the city center. Now, the currently 1 hour trip time from the center of Milan to the airport would be reduced from 1 hour down to 5 minutes. That's how insanely fast Hyperloop would actually be.
So what do you say to the 500,000 pre-orders for the Cybertruck? It's amazing, right? Do you think it will even outsell the Model 3?
And do you think Elon is secretly working on an electric supersonic VTOL drone to replace the F-35 jet? That would be freaking insane.
Be sure to tell us in the comments. So now you have just watched the JS Disruption Report, where we talk about all different kinds of disruptive technologies, from electric cars to flying air taxis, from VTOL jets to Hyperloop.
So then, see you next time. Auf Wiedersehen and on to the future.